Alright, what's up internet? Bibili ka ng casing para sa computer mo and gusto mo siguraduhin na compatible siya sa lahat ng mga parts. So kagaya nung ibang video sa series na to, dadaan tayo sa lahat ng basic parts ng computer tapos check off natin. Ito, kailangan mo tutukan. Ito, hindi. Ito yung mga kailangan mong tutukan. CPU, no need. CPU cooler, yes. You need to check that. Motherboard, yes. GPU, yes. PSU, yes. RGB lighting, not really. Storage, no. And RAM, no. So itong tatlo muna, yung CPU cooler, GPU, and PSU, all of these three things, yung kailangan mo lang tutukan yung sukat nila, yung size. Yung GPU, tingnan mo yung length ng GPU. Kasha ba yun physically? Lahat ng issues usually sa casing, kung physically mapapasok pa yung mga items. Kasi nangyayari, sobrang laki ng ibang items, hindi na siya kasha sa case. So yung GPU, check mo yung length ng GPU na pasok ba sa case. Yung CPU cooler, check mo yung height, kung kasha ba yun sa case. And yung PSU, check mo yung size ng PSU, kung kasha ba siya sa case. To be honest, medyo natatawa ako isipin na ang laki ng CPU cooler, hindi siya kasha sa case. But these things really do happen. Ilang customers na bumalik sa amin, di sila nag-check beforehand, bumili lang ng part, and then bumalik na, ay, ang laki pala nitong CPU cooler na to, hindi pala kasha. Especially if you're looking at medyo smaller cases like the Q300L, or even yung mga Fantex P300A. I mean, these are either M80X cases or smaller ATX cases. You really do need to check on the sizing, especially of these three components. Kung storage naman, kailangan mo lang tutukan kung may available drive base. And usually, especially dun sa malalaking cases, maraming drive base yun. Let's say, sasabihin nila, may limang 3.5-inch drive base, may tatlong 2.5-inch drive base. Drive base are just a fancy way of saying kung saan mo isasaksak yung mga hard drive tsaka yung mga SSD. So if you're thinking that you need a lot of storage, then be sure to get a case with a lot of available drive base. And yun lang yun, basically. Motherboards of different sizes, and usually the most common are ITX. Usually, kapag sinasabi mo ITX, MITX size to yung motherboard. But there are actually two even smaller kinds of ITX na hindi talaga karaniwan, so we won't talk about it anymore. Usually, when you say ITX, you're referring to an MITX board. And then you have MATX, and then ATX, and EATX. So in terms of sizes yun, yung ITX yung pinakamaliit, then MATX, ATX, and EATX. So if you're buying a case, be sure to check your board. Kung ATX case yan, kailangan at least kasha yung ATX mobile dun sa casing mo. Yung sizing niya, the smaller fits in the larger. So may ATX case ka, kasha yung ITX board dun, kasha yung MATX board dun. Yung iba, ayaw nila yung aesthetic. Kasi ang liit ng board mo, ang laki pa ng space dun sa loob ng case. So medyo nakakabitin or hindi maganda tingnan. But that's really just personal preference. There's no specs problem if you want to put an MATX case into an ATX case. There are no compatibility issues with that or your hardware won't slow down. It's just really more concerned about the looks kasi parang, yun nga, some people don't like it na ang laki ng space surrounding the motherboard. So actually, yun lang yun for the case. You just need to make sure about the sizing. If it's a more regular build, like an ATX build, then usually it's easy to find parts. Yung mas challenging yung mga ITX builds na nagiging uso ngayon actually. Yung ITX builds kasi, they try to fit smaller and smaller parts with the same performance as the bigger PCs in a much smaller enclosure, in a much smaller case. Mas challenging yung mga build na yun kasi mas mahal yung parts, mas mahirap makahanap ng ITX parts, and yung tolerances mo or yung clearances, yung sizing dun sa loob ng case, sobrang kailangan exact paminsan. Kasi siksik talaga sila. Mas mahirap din mag-cable management. You know, generally, when you're building a PC, the more space there is, mas madali mag-build ng computer. Kasi hindi ka, yun, yung madaliri mo, di kailangan na talaga nakasaksak dun sa mga little ports and little holes and things like that. Yung uso actually kasi dati, yung sobrang laki na case. Pero ngayon, parang bumabaliktad na, pupunta naman dun sa sobrang liit ITX builds. So para di naman sayang yung time natin, dagdagan pa natin yung information since sobrang dali lang naman ng mga sizing issues na yan, they're easy to check. Usually, when you buy a case, I recommend looking at four different things. Number one, kung may kasama ng RGB. yes, marami sa atin ayaw sa RGB, pero marami rin naman may gusto. And there's no problem with that. Here at Hardware Sugar, we do a lot of RGB builds as well. Para makasulit, maraming cases ngayon may kasama ng RGB. Yung a good example is the Deepcool Matrex 55 Mesh Add RGB 4F. Basically, it just means that it comes with 4 additional addressable RGB fans. Yun, mga 4,500 lang ata yun or something like that. So, sobrang sulit. Another popular choice, pero medyo mahal, yung NZXT H510 Elite. Kasi sobrang ganda ng front panel ng 510 Elite. You can really see the 2 RGB fans there. The Cooler Master H500 ARGB, also a popular choice. So, maraming iba't ibang cases na may kasama ng RGB installed. And if you are looking for RGB, and if you're medyo budget-oriented, it's a good idea to ask your store kung may kasama na ba tong RGB. Again, it's not for everybody, but kung yan yung trip mo, no problem. And there are a lot of manufacturers that cater to that. Usually, masulit kung built-in na yung RGB. Although again, advanced users will prefer to choose their own para mapili talaga nila yung layout ng RGB, kung anong brand ng RGB para ma-set up dun sa software na gusto nila, and things like that. But for, you know, entry-level builders, there's no harm at all in getting a decent case with RGB already built in. Number two, palaging tinatanong sa casing is yung thermals. Or basically, gaano ka-efficient yung case kumuha ng cold air sa labas, i-circulate sa case, and then ilabas or i-exhaust. Because things get really hot in a computer. Yung CPU mo, sobrang init nun. Yung GPU mo, sobrang init. Especially on load. Especially kapag, you know, you're trying to ask it to play a game, you're trying to do streaming or editing. So, the thermals of a case refers to how good it is at sucking in air, making that air flow through the case, and then having an exhaust to bring the hot air out. So, cold air in, circulate, hot air out. And this is more of an advanced concern. For the regular builder, it's like, yeah, medyo concern siya. Pero to be honest, kahit medyo mainit naman yung sa loob, hindi ganun kaganda yung thermals ng casing. Usually, kaya naman yun nung components eh. 2 years, 3 years, they're used to suffering through heat. It's not something like you need to super obsess about na, oh my God, kailangan sobrang ganda ng thermals ng casing ko. And in fact, there are some expensive cases na hindi ganun kaganda yung thermals, like yung nabanggit kong H510 Elite. Maganda tingnan yun, but since all glass yung harap, wala masyadong intake, hindi makakapasok yung cold air. And yet, many people buy it because, to be honest, kahit ako, nagaganda na ako sa case na yun. So good thermals are nice to have, but it's not something the regular user super needs to worry about. Generally, you know, the more fans, you can add fans to most cases, and you know, more fans means better thermals kasi mas maraming air yung nahihigop papasok and mas maraming air yung lumalabas as exhaust. Mas mabilis yung air circulation within the case. Depende din yun kung nasa aircon ka palagi or kung nasa labas ka lang. So thermals are nice to have, and if you want to do additional research, that's very good, and there's a lot of information online. Pero yun nga, for beginners, you don't really need to worry about it too much. Third thing I usually look for in a case is how easy is it to clean. Kasi especially dito sa atin, sobrang maalikabok. Kahit naka-aircon ka or something, ang daming mga dust na nagbe-build up sa loob. And usually most cases have dust filters. Recently lang to naging uso yung sobrang easy to remove dust filters. Cases 5 years back may mga dust filters, pero sobrang hirap nilang tanggalin from the case. Kailangan pang i-detach yung front part and kunin yung dust filter na hindi rin, you know, nakasiksik doon. Ang hirap tanggalin. Nowadays, a lot of cases come with magnetic dust filters, so you just need to take off the dust filter, rinse it or brush it, make sure it's dry, then stick it back on. They usually cover the more noticeable parts of the case, like the bottom, the top, and things like that. General maintenance, like cleaning your case every once a year or 6 months or so, is recommended because, yun, bumabalik tayo sa thermals. Kung daming dust doon sa loob, hindi maganda yung airflow, tataas yung temperatures mo, parang papangit yung thermals mo. And it's really true over time, nagugulat ka pag bukas mo ng case mo. It's not even just the dust filters. Kahit may dust filters yan, kapag chinek mo yung CPU cooler mo, kung air cooling ka, or yung fans ng GPU mo, daming alikabok dun. It's really surprising. And so, It's recommended that you clean it regularly. At kung madaling linisin yung case mo, then mas nakakainganyo kaysa sa, oh God, it's so hard, I need to open it, and dahil pang mga ek-ek. So the easier it is to clean, the more likely it is that you'll do it on a regular basis. And lastly, yung chinecheck ko sa case is yung aesthetics. Iba-iba naman tayo. Yung case na gusto ko, baka hindi mo gusto, and that's fine. That's the beauty of having so many different manufacturers. Like itong case sa likod ko, yung Thermaltake AHT600. I mean, this thing is a beast. It looks really distinct. It's super heavy. It's super large. I think this is an E80X case. It'll fit an E80X motherboard. And we carry it in the shop. Binibenta namin sa Hardware Sugar. Pero ako personally, di ko siya gusto. It sort of looks like the Cougar Conquer, but I like the Cougar Conquer. Yung Conquer kasi parang yung facing niya, yung sa taas yung parang ano niya, bump, or it has a more aggressive look because it emphasizes the top part. Dito naman sa AHT600, para siyang helicopter, yung ini-emphasize niya yung lower part, parang dito siya nagda-jut out. And that's completely fine kung yan yung trip mo. And we do try to carry different styles of casings. And kani-kanya yun based on the customer. I always ask the customer kasi yung case, yung talagang nakikita mo sa computer. You interact with the case every day to turn it on, to, you know, plug it back in or things like that. So for me, the case is really, it's important to get the aesthetics right for a customer. Especially if you have the budget and medyo okay sa'yo na mag, you know, konting gastos para makuha talaga yung look na gusto mo, yung casing sobrang important nun. Some cases I personally love, I really like the TT Core P3, parang open air na case. I think it's a really unique looking design, pwede mo pang i-wall mount. Kung gagawa ako ng build soon, personally for myself, that would be on the short list. I really like the open air aesthetic of the Core P3. Or yung isa pang gusto ko talaga na case, yung Cooler Master, I think it's the SL600M. That's beautiful. It's like in all aluminum. And sobrang magkaiba yung aesthetics noon. Yung Core P3, open air. Yung SL600M, medyo malaki siya. But it's like a flat block of aluminum. Tapos may konting flap pa siya na automated ata, or may mechanical part or something. That's also a beautiful case. I would seriously consider that for my own personal builds. But there are so many, many cases. We carry a lot of them in Hardware Sugar. The NZXT cases are very popular, especially for aesthetics. Ako personally, I don't really like the aesthetic of NZXT. No offense, but medyo I get bored. It's like this very European aesthetic na parang, yeah, it's very austere. And I get it. I mean, it looks nice. Pwede siya sa museum. Hindi lang siya for me. Gusto ko mas aggressive yung enclosures ko, yung casings ko. It is something to consider, especially if you have the budget for it, yung aesthetics ng case na gusto mo. So that's really it for the casing, the things you need to look out for, and maybe some more basic information that might help you deciding on what case you want. I would not get the AHT600, but if you do like that look, then more power. It does look very distinctive. And or baka naman yung type mo, yung sa size lang. So maraming ITX cases. We do have the InWin Chopin or the AWin A1 Plus. All different ITX cases. So yung maganda sa case, ang dami talagang options na available. And if you're willing to research and you're willing to look at the time, I really think you'll find a case that you can fall in love with. Thanks for watching.
So I hope that these basic tips helped you. If you found this video helpful, please drop a like and hit the subscribe button. For your PC needs, consider buying from us, Hardware Sugar, at Lazada, or on our website. You can find links in the description below. And thank you for watching. See you next video.